चतुर्मुख समारंभाम वाग्भटाचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपराम गुरु गणेशाभ्याम नमः। सो थैंक यू वन एंड ऑल फॉर जॉइनिंग इन। सो मेनी नोन नेम्स नोन पीपल आर देयर ऑल्सो। थैंक यू, थैंक्स फॉर जॉइनिंग। सो वी आर again resuming the sessions after a long break actually. Unfortunately, I saw that I recently, while discussing, I understood that we are again starting during the the growing phase of the moon. So that's also a nice nimittam. So as you all must be knowing, our session today is, I'm sharing my screen. So, application of Ayurveda lifestyle. So, basically, we are going to explore the principles, concepts, and various other things just to warm you up before going into the core of the topic. If I just ask a question, what Ayurveda is, the most common answers that I would be getting is, Ayurveda is an ancient medicine. Ayurveda is a preventive medicine. It's a natural, you use all natural substances. You use herbal substances. There are no side effects. And Ayurveda gives prescription for good lifestyle. That is, Ayurveda gives Ayurveda lifestyle advices, Ayurveda food advices. That will be the answer that most probably we will be getting when we ask a question, what Ayurveda is. Maybe can some of you give your perspective of what do you think Ayurveda is? Where is your understanding? What is your understanding about Ayurveda? A life manual is one answer. A life manual is a good way to say that. Science of life. Living in balance with nature, knowledge of life. Yeah. Rishi inspired way to be healthy. All doshas balance. So we get different perspectives. Let us try to understand from a little different perspective, knowledge about how human body reacts to the external environment. We'll see a little different perspective. But if we try to divide the words, that is, Ayurveda is made up of two words, as you must be knowing, Ayuhu and Veda. Veda is crudely translated as knowledge. But if you go into the technical explanation of Veda, the root word Veda is Vid. Vid sattayam vetignyane vinte vichare. So it goes on actually. Vid sattayam, that which exists, that the knowledge or the subject matter that exists, that is available for perception, that is available for understanding, analysis, etc. So it's just not knowledge, it has a deep implication. Ayuhu meaning life. So Ayurveda covers everything about life. Ayurveda is a way of life. Ayurveda is not something that deals with herbs or herbal medicine, or it's not just a preventive medicine. It deals with every single aspect of life that we can imagine of. There is nothing left out. It is that vast a subject matter. So bringing this information close to our topic, we can tell that living a life in harmony with nature is a simplified explanation of Ayurveda when we try to understand Ayurveda and our lifestyle modifications. So living a life in harmony with nature, meaning there are a lot of principles that is principles of nature that we experience and that we sometimes experience, sometimes don't experience, but there are a lot of principles of nature which are governing us. Can someone tell us the most important principles that are governing our day-to-day life? Can anyone share what are the principles of nature that dictate our life, our daily life? What are the three main principles based on which our daily life is going forward? Principles of nature. Gunas. No, principles of nature. Gunas. Whatever principle of nature we try to understand, it has some gunas or properties. Lakshmi Balasu. Season, day, time. Season, movement of the sun, time. Moon, earth, sun, movements. Vata, Pitta, Kapha. We get multiple answers. Principles of nature which governs us. Actually, our daily life is primarily influenced by three principles of nature. Primarily, I would call it as sun and moon and the earth on which we are sustaining. Principles of nature or principles of universe. This earth is providing our nourishment and all that. We are surviving on this planet Earth, and all other factors which creates day, night, movement, etc. is basically with the influence of sun and moon. Of course, there is something called Kala. Kalohi nama Bhagavan. So Kala is inevitable. We cannot avoid Kala. Kala, the time factor, is definitely there. But the sun and moon has a strong influence in our daily living. So coming to the third point that I have mentioned, living a life in harmony with nature, in other way around, living a life in harmony with the principles of nature is Ayurveda. So this is the key that our ancestors or our forefathers were using to lead a healthy life. That is, all their life, our ancestors' life, were connected with the principles of nature, primarily the day and night. They start with the day, they start with the sun and end with the moon. So that is how the nature was, how their life was going on. Unfortunately or fortunately, because of a lot of scientific advancements, etc., it is not unfortunate in all aspects, but in few aspects it is unfortunate, especially when it comes to health. With the scientific advancements and stuff like that, we have traveled little away from the principles of nature, which I'm going to explain. And if we understand that, yes, I have traveled away from this concept of nature or the principle of nature, and if you get a clue how to get back to that concept of nature or the principle of nature, we are successful in this 90 minutes to sow the seed to have a healthy life. So this is going to be our mission in this next 80 minutes or 90 minutes or so. So basically, to understand how have we traveled away from this principles of nature and how to get back, why to get back, what is the logic behind getting back to this principle, that is going to be the focus of this topic. Our forefathers did not have an option but to follow the principles of nature, meaning they had their own tradition, and that tradition was particular and specific in each regions. Every country, every region, every state, every place had their own traditions. People living in different places had their own traditions. This tradition was not a standard practice. It was not a standard prescription. It was not a standard practice. For example, in India, in Tamil Nadu, the traditional practices are different. Kerala, the traditional practice of different. If you go up north, the practices are different. So each of us, according to the place where we are, we had our own traditional practices. If we dig deeper, we can understand that these traditional practices are nothing but going in harmony or going parallel, hand in hand with the nature. It might be confusing for you now, but we are going to experience this in this next few minutes. Experiential understanding by examples and things like that. So our forefathers were perfectly following Ayurveda without knowing. Maybe they did not even know the word what Ayurveda is. They would not have even heard the word Ayurveda, but they were following Ayurveda unknowingly. And they followed it and they also transferred it to every one of us in the name of tradition. But with all these advancements and things like that, this tradition got lost. The bigger picture is lost. We believe these traditions are superstitious, or sometimes it doesn't make sense because we don't have that. The thread is gone. We've lost the thread. So we believe that it is not, these traditions doesn't make sense, etc. So if I am in Tamil Nadu, our traditions are different because my Ritukala Desha, my season, my climate, my exterior environment, everything is different. So my life is depending upon how my exterior environment is. When you are in the US or when you are in Singapore or wherever you are, the natives had their own tradition according to their environment. So actually it is specific to their environment. That precise Ayurvedas. So if someone is expecting a prescription here, for example, you are here to understand how can I bring Ayurveda into my lifestyle? Give me some standard prescriptions to bring in Ayurveda into my lifestyle. Actually speaking, there are no standard prescriptions. We have a huge freedom. It's like a game of chess, actually. There are certain regimen, there are certain rules. That is like a game of chess. Okay, the king moves this way, the queen moves this way, the soldier can go only one step, etc. There are certain rules. But every game we play would be different. No two people can play a game of chess in the same way. Or I cannot play the same way all the time. Each game is different. Similarly, for each of us, there are set of rules, but it cannot be the same for everyone. It should be highly customized. People believe that this customization is very difficult. Actually, it is no. If you understand the ground reality, if you understand the basic concepts, it is going to be so easy.